Find your head, toes out. Sumo squat. It's a good morning. Core engaged. A little soft bend in the knees. Well, here it comes. We've had some beautiful weather lately.
You guys.
Did you just say that?
We've had.
Oh, yes.
One more time. All right, bring those feet together. Narrow squat. Hip circle. Straight leg kick. Hip hinge. And we'll do it on the other side. Narrow squat. Hip circle. Straight leg kick. Hip hinge. My mom says it's been raining like crazy in Florida. I think this is the first rain we've had in a while.
It is.
The whole time when Mike was in the hospital, it was gorgeous. I was like, that's why I got the nurses to agree to let me take him outside.
Did they not want to let you do that?
Well, they just don't normally do that. Like,
yeah.
There's a liability issue.
I'm surprised they let you then. Did you have to sign a form, going outside at Rex?
They let us do, I know, right? They let us do a lot of things they don't normally let people do. Like, they let Mike walk by himself.
Oh!
Which normally you have to have somebody with you.
Sure.
Alright, last one, both sides. Alright, alternating abduction.
Yeah.
All right, in between, we're going to add a heel raise. Starting with a split stance squat. It's going to be like this, just a single leg squat. Both sides. Then we'll go into sliding laterals. Slow. I'm only going to give you two for now, so you don't have too much in your head. All right, split stance squat. So we've got 30 seconds on, 15 seconds to switch. So I'm giving you a generous amount of recovery. What's that about?
It's like I've never exercised before.
It's true. Keep that core engaged, hips back, weight primarily in that front heel. I'm crackling. Nobody's business. 5 seconds. All right, 15 seconds off, we go to the other side. Three, two, go. That back foot is just for balance. Squeeze that glute at the top. 15 seconds. Down low or up at a chest level. sweaty already. I think I want heavier next round.
Pardon?
I'm gonna do heavier next round. I'm gonna use your 20s. You can take the 25s.
I can give you this. I have no issue.
And rest. Other side.
You want
we'll
it
see.
Now?
We're not even like halfway through the round, so let's just see what happens. All right, other side. Bend in the knee, hinge at the hips, weight in that front heel. Man, these shoes are already tilting. Good thing they're blue. Step forward. Halfway. Woo! Woo, yeah. Other side. Mike says he feels like a blob.
Already?
He's not doing anything. Well, he was told not to do any workouts prior to having the surgery, too.
Right.
He's ready to go back.
Lose all the fluid?
Oh, yeah. And then some.
Yeah.
10 seconds.
It's amazing how the body deals with crisis.
I know, right? All right, next is a sumo squat. Just a basic sumo squat. Three, two, go. Halfway. Seconds. know, Catherine. I don't know about that second week.
No?
My eyes were bigger than my stomach when we first started. It hurt me. All right, second round. We're going to attempt three here. Three rounds.
Oh, okay, the same.
I don't know if we'll have time though. All right, 12 seconds. We got that single leg split stance squat. Try not to lock out that knee at the top. In the knee, squeeze the glute at the top, weight in that heel, core engaged, neutral spine. And rest. All right, walking lunge with a pulse. So I've been taking my vitamins pretty religiously.
Yeah.
And Tuesday, when I took them, right after I had lunch, and I got a phone call about a golf lesson. I had trouble staying on the phone with the guy because I thought I was going to throw up.
And you took a little food?
And then, when I got off the phone with him, I went into the bathroom and I like stood over the toilet for about 10 minutes. Like, excessively.
Do you usually take them at noon?
Yeah.
Then was it something you ate?
I don't know. I never ended up throwing up. It passed.
Because that's odd that that would suddenly change.
It doesn't necessarily. It's not unique because I get nauseous every time I take my vitamins. But that was the first time I ever got like
nauseous.
Yeah, to the point where I really thought I was going to throw up. And I really just didn't want to throw up all that food.
Such a waste.
All right, sumo squats. Such a waste.
Sure.
Feel like those heels are pulling in toward one another at the top. Three, two, one. Battery died. Okay. Lord have mercy. Water break. Did you see that old video of Cookie that we found?
Of you dragging her? Did you get any negative responses?
No, I got none. It didn't go viral, so.
That was hilarious. I showed Chris that one.
She's such a brat.
Bluetooth pairing. Bluetooth connected.
All right. Final round. Oh, we'll definitely have plenty of time.
And think it's been since July that I've been all over the place.
Well, it's been since your mother-in-law moved here, right?
Yeah, but you know, I went to Illinois. I went to Florida twice.
Wait, when did you go to Illinois?
In July.
Why don't I remember that?
Because I think you've had a few other things going on.
Not in July. Is that where Emily lives?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I knew you went to see her. That's right. I forgot. For some reason, I thought she lived in, like, Ohio. They're all the same, though. All the states when you get up there.
Illinois is a bad one.
But, you know, some of the suburbs are nice.
Oh, and but they live in this tiny little town. Like, it doesn't even really have a grocery store.
Oh, really?
Like, it is tiny.
Is it nice? No.
It's out in nowhere land. Like, you gotta drive through miles and miles of cornfields.
Better than Chicago.
Oh, for sure. And they like it.
Woo! Alright, split stance RDL. I like visiting Chicago. I would never want to live there, though. But I love visiting, like, New York and Boston. I'd never want to live there.
I used to would like to live in New York, just for, if I knew it was a certain time period.
Oh, yeah. I think the 20s, roaring 20s.
No, like if I knew I was only gonna stay there a year.
Oh yeah. Mike and I talk about that all the time. Like when we watch House Hunters or Love It or List of these people that wanna live right in a city, it's like, once you get to a certain age, you don't wanna like be around people anymore. You know? Ugh, people. People are annoying.
Yeah, but I was talking to Joel last night. Like, I noticed a huge difference from not working. Like, my social skills are dwindling quickly.
Really?
I believe so, yes. I just don't care. I just am happy to stay home and not deal with people.
Well, you deal with me.
I told him. I said I go and work out, but it's with a very small group.
All right, walking lunges, double pulse.
We keep looking for land, but
I was telling the other guys today. I'm like, or even the other day, Saturday. You know, I wouldn't be doing these classes if I didn't absolutely love it. Like, I'm not really pushing it. Like, so we were talking about if this space went away, like getting an indoor space.
Oh.
I would never do that. Like, I wouldn't do it. The reason I'm doing this is because my overhead is low enough where I don't have to be like, I'm selling memberships. I hate that. And if I start feeling like I have to meet a quota, I'm not gonna enjoy it anymore.
Yeah.
Like the reason I do it and I love it is because first of all, I know, like I don't make money off of it, but it does force me to work out.
Yes.
Like when I'm not here teaching, it is not part of my routine to come out here and work out on my own.
No. And I understand that too.
Plus, like I know you guys are super forgiving if I like take time off. Everybody's really like supportive and stuff. If I get a group of people that I don't know.
Oh yeah, it becomes a much larger responsibility.
Yeah. And I still try to do right by you guys. Like when I'm gonna be gone, I try to get Allison to teach as much as possible. But it becomes a job.
Sure.
When I have to start like making money at it. And now it feels kind of like a hobby.
Well, thank you for having hobbies.
All right, kettlebell swing to squat swing. I'm so grateful that this is the last one of these. Until I have to demo later tonight.
You may just stay just like earlier since you were gone. Might as well keep going, right?
What do you mean?
When you demo.
Oh, no. No, not tonight. Also because I'm planning on taking a shower in the middle of my day today, which is not the norm for me.
Yeah, why are you doing that?
I have two golf lessons this afternoon. I just think it would be a nice
gesture.
Nice gesture. One of them I don't know, so.
Oh, yeah, first impressions.
The other one I preferred if she didn't come back. Oh, there it was. She was, this particular student came to our group golf class and was really ugly to one of the younger instructors.
Really?
Yeah, just not cool.
I don't get that.
Like, it was a group short game class where they play the course. So there's a little bit of instruction, but not a ton. And she wasn't hitting the ball well, and she said to the instructor, I need some instruction. Do I need to go to another group? And then she said, the girl gave her some advice, and she goes, well, that's not what Lauren told me. And this girl's like, I've been teaching under only Mike. Like, he's the only instructor that tells me love and ease. The only instructor that tells me to teach. So anything that I learn and teach other people is learned from him.
Right.
So who knows if she misinterpreted what I told her or she was just...
So in your course, you didn't learn anything different from what Mike has taught you?
No.
That's pretty good.
Well, so David Ledbetter has this signature A swing. All right, we're gonna do a step out squat to adduction. So it's step out squat, adduction, both sides. So we start at 12, we grab a sip of water. So he has this signature swing called the A swing or the alternate swing, which is quite frankly just gimmicky.
Okay.
Like a lot of these golf instructors try to trademark something that's not super inventive. And it's like an alternate swing for somebody who's an average golfer, doesn't really have a whole lot of time to practice. But it's sort of counter to a lot of like the fundamentals that we're taught as golf instructors. So it's hard to teach it. That's the only thing that's different. But most of the people that go into that Ledbetter certification don't have experience teaching.
Oh, okay.
And so I went into it having already taught for like 3 years.
Sure.
So it was sort of a breeze for me. All right, drop squats are next for the guy Stuart, who is my like preceptor. He was kind of like, it was an easy easy for him to do. Like, he'd give me a swing to analyze. And I'd pick out priorities in their swing.
Okay.
So it was pretty easy to do. And I've been watching Mike teach for a long time. Well, those experiences, though. All right, bridge abduction. Preferably weighted.
Those pictures of Caden as that little child swinging. Like, I thought, wow, you have been doing this a long time.
Yep. All right, so it's going to be a bridge abduction. So those events where we would travel were really helpful.
Okay. Do you miss that at all?
Huh?
Do you miss that at all?
I miss the traveling a little bit.
Sure.
Oh, but the work.
Yes.
It was such long days. And we didn't make that much money.
Yeah.
Like, we're making more money here. All right, next is going to be a half crab hold adduction. So remember these. Option to keep the hips on the floor. I am wobbly. Switch sides. So in some, I miss the people too. Like, we got along with some of the people there.
Yeah,
pretty well. After this, we're going to hop it up to banded jacks. All right, banded jacks.
Still pull over here?
Yeah. Just change it up. Three, two, one. All right, this might need to go up. So we're going into single leg deadlift to forward lunge. Band might not even be
cooperative.
Woo! jump squat. So it's one, two, three, jump. Go. What?
Just me.
Are you miscounting?
Just doing stupid stuff. Stupid extras that are not necessary.
Woo! Alright. Breaky break. Wow. That got higher than I expected.
113. Chris on Saturday, we did like a run walk, a couple, and it went up to 172.
Wow. So he's running? Yeah. Does he still have problems with his hamstring?
Oh yeah.
That's crazy.
It aches, and most of the time he can walk through it.
You think it's just scar tissue?
Yeah, it's just,
that sucks. That's quite an injury.
Oh. Terrible.
All right, round two.
But he can get through it. It just takes him some time. Right, he's got to walk slow for a while. And then he can, but he only walk runs now.
Does he ever foam roll it?
Not anymore.
I wonder if the foam rolling would help.
Probably.
Decrease the scar tissue. Halfway.
Zach's got his half marathon in a couple weeks. And then 13 on Saturday.
Oh yeah? Good for him.
Yeah.
What's he doing this time?
He's just going to school.
Okay.
It's interesting. Because he has to take psychology and American history, and finds it extremely difficult to listen to the drivel. Like in one class they started genders on.
Oh Jesus. I remember I took a women's studies class in college at UNC. It was actually my senior year because I needed that elective to graduate.
Yeah.
So it was filled with freshmen. Drop squat. And these freshmen, particularly girls, were so impressionable.
Yeah.
And they just took whatever the professor said.
Yes.
As fact. And I was like, I remember, you know Walter Williams?
No.
He's an economist. He taught economics at, crap, what college? I don't remember. All right, bridge abduction. Conservative.
Okay.
Black guy. He just recently passed away. Like Thomas Sowell type guy.
Okay.
In fact, they were pretty close, I think. So in college, I had this women's studies class, and I wrote a paper. And I don't remember what it was about, but I remember I was being contrary
oh.
to whatever they were teaching, and like it was a little argumentative.
Yeah.
And I failed it.
Yeah.
And I remember I wrote to Walter Williams.
Oh.
Half bridge or half crab abduction. I wrote to him, emailed him, and said, do you have any advice for like a college student who basically thinks for herself? He's like, tell them what they want to hear.
Yeah.
If you want an A in the class, you gotta.
Yeah.
You gotta just.
Isn't that terrible?
Yeah, it's terrible. But he was like, you need to stand by your convictions, and if you're gonna get through the class, you need to tell them what they want to hear.
Yeah.
And I got an A in the class.
Because that's not hard to tell them what.
No.
That's easy.
Oh, you can just stroke their ego and their ace.
Zach has said he's glad he's there now, not
when he was right
5 years ago. Yeah, 6 years ago.
Okay. I hope Caden doesn't go to college right away.
Yeah.
Although I think she's already got a pretty good sense of the way things work sometimes.
Yeah.
I tried, when Walter Williams died just recently, I tried to find the email that he sent me.
Oh, okay.
But it must have been an old email address. I couldn't find it. Whew. All right, Bandit Jacks.
I didn't expect to sweat this much today.
I know. We both.
He's doing really well, though. So that's...
Zach?
Yes.
Good.
Yes, it's a really...
Where is he taking classes?
Wake.
Okay. That's the way to do it.
Oh, for sure.
Is he getting it paid for?
Yes.
Good.
I think it's like $1,500 a month.
Maybe Caden will join the military.
I don't know. There would have to be a huge change.
I know. You're right.
Because it was not good for Zach.
Really?
He looked...
I do think Caden would be a great nurse.
Well, see, and the thing of it is, girls are different. Well, everybody's different. But Zach's not going to be the one to research everything to see how they can benefit him the most.
Oh yeah?
He'll just ride the ride, right? Maybe now he would be different.
Not make waves, you mean?
Just not even look for, like, what kind of education can I have here? What can benefit me here?
Yeah.
Whereas, like, what was that girl's, they came to the gym. He was a colonel. She was that cute, tiny little. She was always in the front of the class. Blonde. She would bring her daughters to gym. They could do like pull-ups and stuff. Stephanie.
Stephanie.
She was tiny.
Anyway, oh yeah, Stephanie.
Like her, their daughters. All have had great success in the military.
I don't know that I knew that they were in the military.
Yeah. Well, one's married to a SEAL. One's going to school to be a anesthetist. They're paying for it. And one is like way high up. They went to Hawaii for one of the ceremonies where she was.
I wonder if she's back at the gym.
Yes.
She is.
But they're very afraid.
Oh, are they?
Yeah. One of their daughters won't get the
rest
vaccine.
Really?
That upsets them.
All right, one more round. Let's get it done with. Step out squat adduction. I miss like Jeannie.
Yeah.
Who else did I miss? Stephanie, James.
Yeah, they moved to Florida. Anyway.
She reached out to me right before Mike had his surgery because you know Charlie had a big heart open heart surgery.
What was his?
His, I think, was a valve replacement, I think. She told me in the message.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
But I was like, that really helps. Like, we've heard from a ton of people that have had the surgery, but from nobody who's experienced it as the spouse.
Oh.
And it really helped me to, like,
oh, good.
Talk to her about it. Like, she was saying, like, she had her moments where she broke down, but she really tried to do it where the kids and Charlie didn't see it. She didn't want them to know how worried she was. And she was saying the hardest thing was when the kids saw him with all the tubes.
Yeah.
And he looked kind of like gray and didn't look himself. All right, drop squat. It was very helpful talking to her. He's gonna have another surgery, and she said it's not gonna be open heart this time.
Oh, okay.
So that's good. But I remember when he had it done.
Yes.
Because I remember him coming to the gym. I remember he was having such a weird, like, tachycardia.
Okay.
And he'd be in spin class, and he'd have to, like, stop because his heart rate was way too high. And then he would, like, go into AFib. So I remember when he had the surgery, and I came in to the gym shortly after that. All right, bridge abduction. But yeah, it was very helpful to talk to her. You know, I was very concerned about seeing Mike with all the tubes in.
Yeah.
And, like, not moving. It really didn't bother me that much.
Do you think that's because they prepared you for it?
Maybe. But he didn't look that bad. Like, they said, oh, he's going to look like he's dead. I thought he just looked like he was sleeping.
Yeah. That picture you said.
What? Oh, the first day?
He's so obviously drugged up.
His brother made me take a video.
Oh.
When he was drugged.
Was he funny?
Well, he said, Mom. Hi, Danny. Hi, Mom. I lived.
Aw.
I think it's a pretty good thing. I think it's a pretty sure thing that I'm going to live.
Aw.
But I'm being a pain in the ass to these nurses. So they might kill me first.
I know that feeling though, when you go under, like, you don't know if you're gonna wake up, right? It's a little bit of a...
You know what's very fascinating to me though? And this made me think about, like, death in a different perspective. Like, for Mike, when he was under, it was easily 8 hours of him being under anesthesia.
Yeah.
He felt like it was seconds.
Yeah.
And you just wonder if, when we die, if it's similar.
Like, how so? How do you mean?
Like, hours become seconds, and
except it's eternity.
Right.
Maybe.
No. Maybe our energy transfers. All right, banded jacks.
Well, you know how I believe, so.
What?
I said you know how I believe, so.
Right. Said he had a dream, but he couldn't remember it.
Oh, interesting.
Because his mom said, did you dream anything while you were under? And he said, yeah. He said, I did dream something, but I can't remember it. And he didn't realize that until she asked him.
Last night I dreamt they were poisoning all our trees and fruit, and because I'm reading this book, you know, about polio and how they were spraying arsenic and lead on everything.
Yeah.
Well, then that became unpopular. So they started spraying DDT on every time.
Right.
They would go through the streets with it, and the kids would run under it, and
God,
they'd pour it on crops and trees. Whew. Crazy, man.
It is crazy. It's crazy what our government does to people.
Yeah, and we're
people. Well, you are obviously anxious. Obviously have some anxiety.
Oh, I do. Chris is wound up tighter than I. I have trouble separating my stress level from his.
I realize some of my anxiety stems from reading the comments on WRAL's articles. So I stopped doing that.
I know.
It's so...
I think
and they're all stupid.
Should I read this? Should I read this?
And then I read it and I'm like, people arguing with each other and I'm like, you're both stupid. Like, and people that have no problem displaying their stupidity are the worst. And my favorite is when they call each other stupid. That's my favorite. When they call each other stupid and proceed to have poor grammar in their posts. 5 seconds.
So Erica's new job is,
and rest.
Marks. She checks grammar on people's essays. And
oh, so she can do that from home.
Yes.
That's awesome.
So, all the way up to doctorate. She says it's pretty bad.
Is it?
Yeah.
I remember my mom had a, she had a guy working for her when she had her, like, drug and alcohol counseling business.
Oh, your mom had that business?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, for years she had it.
Interesting.
And she had a guy that worked with her who had his master's. He had his master's. Had. And he, her, his, like, write-ups and his reports were so poorly written, she could not, in good conscience, submit them.
Oh.
So she would have to, like, they were so bad. And he had a freaking master's.
Yeah.
I worry about Caden. Her writing skills are not great, and I don't know how to help her.
Just practice?
It's not so much, it's like the ability to formulate.
Oh.
Like an essay.
Oh, yeah, I get it.
Like introduction, body, conclusion. The fact that your introduction doesn't need to have all these details in them.
There's got to be a course on that.
Yeah.
Get her to take a course on it. Then it's not coming from you.
It's a good idea. Like a creative writing course.
Yeah. That's the thing, like, there's so many resources.
Yeah, there really is. I just joined two or three Facebook groups for homeschoolers, homeschooling parents. So hopefully that'll help. A little bit.
Did you see the big kerfuffle between Cooper and the lieutenant governor?
Oh no, but not surprised.
They were teaching, there was like in books pictures of homosexual acts.
Oh, I saw that the lieutenant governor was in hot water for some things.
He called it filth, that filth shouldn't be in school, and so people took that as homosexuality is filth.
Right. Yeah, they misinterpreted what he said.
In that one call, the guy says, you should hang, nigger. Like, just yapping and yapping and yapping.
Wow.
It's terrible.
That really seems to make sense.
The accepting left, right? I'm sure if it was a heterosexual couple, he would have said the same thing. It doesn't belong in school.
Man, I would not be putting that stuff in a book, for sure. That's a required reading for kids. like that he didn't back down from it.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, and say what you will about the guy, at least he stands for his, like, principles, you know?
I heard him speak. He was a good speaker,
didn't he?
Very strong in his faith.
Hinge to the right.
He's a big man.
Yeah, he is a big guy. Back up, deep breath in. Exhale down. Woo, that was a good one.
Sick.
Sweaty.